Hello everyone, my name is Melvin. Welcome to Koinix Solutions. Today we are going to discuss about malware analysis. So malware analysis can be done in two ways. One is static analysis and other one is dynamic analysis. So in static analysis, what we are going to do is we have to take this malware, right, that executable file, and we are going to disassemble it, or we are going to do reverse engineering. So there are some tools available for disassembling a binary file. That is, for example, IDA Pro is a good one. So with IDA Pro, what you can do is you can disassemble a binary file, right, which will allow us to have the machine code. So if you have good knowledge in assembly language, then it is an added advantage for doing this kind of malware analysis. So dynamic analysis means we are going to execute that malware, right? We are going to run the malware in a constrained environment. That means in a sandboxy environment. For example, you have a VMs, right? You have a lot of VMs. In a VM, if you run the malware and if you do analysis, right, it will not affect the base machine. Whatever happens is happens inside only the VM. So this is called as dynamic analysis. So today I'm going to discuss with you about some of the tools from sysinternals. See, there is a site called as sysinternals.com. So for that you can go to Google and type sysinternals. The first results is Windows sysinternals. That's it. You click on this site and go to the downloads, and in the downloads you can see sysinternals. Just click on it and download it. After that you have to extract it. After extracting it, you can see a bunch of files like this, which is very useful for doing this kind of malware analysis. So here I am going to use a tool called as Process Explorer. Minimizing this and opening this. This is a Process Explorer. So first of all, if you want to do a malware analysis, right, you want to check whether any unnecessary services are running. Whenever a machine is infected with malware, there may be some unnecessary services will be running. So with the help of these tools, you can find out what are the system's default process and what are all the unnecessary process. So first here, you can see here, there is a process called a system, right? This is the default process. Whenever you power on your machine, right, whenever the Windows loads, at that time itself, this process will get loaded. So always the PID, the process ID for this process is 4. And system process runs from ntoskernel.exe. So after this, there is a process called as services.exe. The parent for this services.exe process is winint.exe. This is the parent for this services.exe. So this services.exe might have many child process, right? And always you have to check whether it is this services.exe is loaded from the default location. For example, the default location is C Windows System 32. How will you check that? For example, you can click here. You can click TCP IP. Okay, showing some error. So you can double click on the services.exe, it will open up a pop-up. In that you can find from which location this process has been executed. So this service process here, this services might have a lot of child process. So after this, there is a process called as CSRSS. Let's see, where is the CSRSS? See, here is the process CSRSS. This CSRSS process stands for Client Server Runtime Subsystem. And I'm giving you one hint, many of the viruses and malwares run in this process only. So you have to check. And always remember one thing, this CSRSS process should not have any parent process, right? After this, we have one process called as winlogon. So whenever you press Ctrl Alt Delete, and it is asking you username and password to log in, right? Whenever you click on this Ctrl Alt Delete, and when you are giving the credentials to log in, this username and password, right, it is sent to another process called as lsass.exe. I will show you this lsass.exe. See here. See, whenever you press Ctrl Alt Delete, it will show up the screen in which you have to enter the username and password. This is handled by winlogon.exe. After that, that username and password for validation, it is going to a process called as lsass.exe. This is the process. So this lsass.exe stands for Local Security Authority Subsystem, which will authenticate the local users. After authentication, it will go to some other process called as LSM, Local Session Manager, which will, the job of this LSM is to manage the sessions. So these are all some of the system's default process. So if you find anything here like random, with random names like ABCC, EX112, like this, if there is any process running, that might be your system might get infected with malware. So using a process explorer tool itself, you can do this kind of analysis if you know what are all the default process for Windows, right?